To pay someone back. This is something you do when someone buys something for you and you want to pay them back. You want to give them that money back to them. Although usually we talk about paying someone back with money, it doesn't always have to be with money. Maybe someone does something nice for me, I want to pay them back. So someone came and brought my stuff for me when I forgot it, then I went and bought them a coffee. That's how I paid them back. Another way that we use the word pay back is when we want to take revenge on someone. If someone does something really mean to me, I want to pay them back. I want to get payback. Maybe if someone stole my shoes, I go back and I steal their backpack, right? I'm paying them back. It's payback. So another similar expression that kind of sounds the same is to pay something off. To pay something off when it comes to money means you've been paying for something for a long time. Maybe it's a car, right? You don't pay for the whole car at once. You pay in little installments every single month. When you finally pay it off, it's the last payment. You just paid for the entire thing. You're finally done with it. Maybe if you bought a house, you're paying many payments, and finally the last payment, you paid it off. A little bit different from paying someone back.
All right, great. Any final words?
If someone does something nice for you, make sure you pay them back and do something nice back for them.
Wow!
English! Payback! 오늘의 표현입니다. Pay back이라는 것은 pay라는 게 지불하는 거잖아요. 근데 back이라는 것은 결국은 어때요? 누가 나한테 뭐를 pay했을 때 내가 그것을 다시 payback하는 느낌이죠. 친구가 저한테 커피를 사줬어요. 고맙잖아요. 그래서 내가 어때요? 친구한테 저녁을 사줬습니다. 그럼 결국 어때요? 내가 페이백하는 거예요. 사실 돈에만 사용하는 게 아니라 이런 식으로도 어떤 걸 갚아주다라고 할 때도 사용이 가능하거든요. 그렇죠? 자, 그리고 또 기억해야 될 것은 뭐 많이 나오는 그런 상황은 아니겠지만 누가 나한테 정말 힘들게 했어요. 그렇죠? 누가 내 돈을 훔쳐갔습니다. 그러면요 짜증날 거 아니에요. 그렇죠? 그러면 그때 I'm gonna pay you back 이렇게 하면 어때요? 내가 갚아주다란 말이에요. 거기서는 어떤 느낌이에요? 복수하다는 말이죠. 이렇게 페이백이라는 게 두 가지 의미가 있다는 거 알고 넘어가시고요. 그리고 헷갈릴 수 있는 표현이 바로 뭐냐면 페이오프라는 표현입니다. 이 페이오프라는 표현 같은 경우는 페이백이라는 게 갚는 느낌이라면요. 페이오프 같은 경우는 다 갚아버리는 거예요. 예를 들어서 내가 차를 살 때 보통 차를 할부로 사잖아요. 그렇죠? 자 그러면 조금씩 조금씩 페이백을 하는 거죠. 페이백, 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 페이백 하다가 결국은 마지막 48개월이 끝났습니다. 그때 결국 어때요? I pay off my car. 이렇게 할 수 있겠죠. 다 갚아버릴 때 우리가 pay off라는 표현. off라는 건 끝나는 느낌이니까 자, pay off라는 표현을 사용할 수 있겠습니다.
You could pay off your mortgage. You could pay off your mortgage. You could pay off your mortgage.
I should be able to pay off the car. I should be able to pay off the car. I should be able to pay off the car.
Whatever we borrow, we pay back. 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 Whatever we borrow, we pay back.
Well, I'll pay you back all the money you invested. Well, I'll pay you back all the money you invested. Well, I'll pay you back all the money you invested. Well, I'll pay you back all the money you invested. Well, I'll pay you back all the money you invested.
Dad's gonna loan me the money to pay back their advance. Dad's gonna loan me the money to pay back their advance. Dad's gonna loan me the money to pay back their advance. Dad's gonna loan me the money to pay back their advance. Dad's gonna loan me the money to pay back their advance.
자, 여러분들 오늘 표현 payback 꼭 기억하고 넘어가시는 거 잊지 마시고요. 우리 그럼 또 다음 시간에 뵙도록 하겠습니다. See you guys next time. Bye bye.